I am a mountain, I am a tall tree. Oh, I am a swift wind sweeping the country. I am a river.
Man was created with dominion, but only blessings can activate this dominion. Compliment of the season, and welcome to your favorite show, The Boldest, with your babe, Esther Obiesie, aka Esther Chime. How are you preparing for the Christmas celebration? Of course, we're already in the season, and I know everywhere is bubbling. With the things we are seeing around town, it is obvious that we are getting prepared, and it is a good one. And I hope, too, that while you're getting prepared physically, materially, you're also getting your heart prepared. For what shall it profit a man who gained the whole wide world? But if you know no Jah, I say all is vanity. That's what I'm saying. Christmas is for those who knows Jah, Jesus Christ. So as we prepare for the Owambe, Christmas light everywhere, let's also remember that we have to prepare for our hearts. Enough of the preaching. Pastor Esther Shine. Tonight I have loads as usual. Loads of interesting packages for you. I have the show that will blow your mind. There is a profession that you and I know. In fact, this is something we practice almost daily, but we never took it serious. We have never paid attention to it as a serious profession. Why? Because this is something we do, we like doing, but we are not categorizing it per se as a profession. I will tell you what that profession is. And also, we are going to give you our usual food for thought from our favorite Ojare, who has been mentoring us on entrepreneurship, how he started his life, and how we should go about it while doing our businesses. But before I unleash all this, let's go on a short break. We will be right back. Please stay tuned.
Never waste your time, never let you go. Top down, back to back, you the best I know. Oh yeah, you the blow my mind, blow my mind, blow my mind. For your love, I go change my life, change my life, change my life. Yeah, but come here to your dance, make us man ego. Dirty white for me, nice ass.
Of colors and mesmerizing moments are what makes life worth living. Rolling around here and feeling the freshness of heaven is what you will get. Ojare Motel on Uchugbo is a home you call your home. Ojare gives you exciting moments with your loved ones with an award-winning restaurant with fresh local and foreign produce, traditional and contemporary bar services, customer care per excellence. At Ojare, we give you the opportunity to keep fit with our long tennis courts, swimming pools, and lots more. Ojare also boasts of a good parking space, beautiful garden, car hire services to take you around town. Ojare, a home you call your home. Ojare is situated in Onuchugbo, Delta State, Nigeria. For booking and inquiries, please call
070-6288-7784.
Oh, Jerry, a home you call your home.
Make me rendezvous. When I drink from your water, give me a cup. I just wanna sip. I'm tryna steal your love. I'm guilty of it. I don't give a shit about who telling all our business when I'm killing it, when I'm feeling it, kissing it and turning to an animal. Yeah, yeah, girl, I fuck with a attitude. Angry and you're dangerous. It don't matter, no. Cause your body controlling me. It don't matter now.
Hello, my people. How you doing? This is Don Bramble, the Don of Nollywood. I'm here to tell you to keep watching The Bold.
Welcome back to your favorite show, The Boldest. I am still here, your babe, Esther Obiesie, aka Esther Shine. Now, number one that we are going to show you on tonight's material is on that profession I told you about. And the question is, what is this profession? This profession is the driving profession. Are you surprised? Don't be surprised. Driving is something we do as fun. Driving is also something that some people do to earn a living. Driving also is something that some set of people do as a hobby. Now, what is driving to you? Are you a driver in a motor park? Are you driving for a company or a bank? Are you driving yourself? If you fall under these categories, why do you drive? Could it be that you have passion for driving? Could it be that you don't like it, but that is the only available source of your living? What is the reason behind your driving? As for me, I like driving. I drive because I like it. It makes me feel relaxed. I enjoy myself whenever I am driving. I have this passion for driving. And sorry, when you see me driving, you think I'm a man. Same with you there. Now, to package this profession for people to actually respect it, because we don't see anything so special about driving. We underrate drivers, no matter how dressed they are, no matter how educated they are. We say, after all, a driver. You see a learned man, a company manager or guy out there ordering the driver. Your driver don't turn to your car wash. Your driver don't turn to your mechanic. Your driver don't turn to your cook. Your driver don't turn to, in fact, your messenger. Why? Because this person is driving you. It is not correct. Now, if you are driving in a motor park, you, as a driver, you feel that after all, na motor park. So you will not bait. Some drivers, if they come close to you, wow, it's terrible. The kind of odor you perceive is, you feel like fainting. All because you just feel, I beg, maybe that kabu they drive. No. Driving is a real profession. It is an expensive profession, a profession that we should guard. No wonder people came out, teamed up, and they have released or unveiled this profession to be a very important profession. Not just unveiling it. Yes, we already know driver. We know driving. But the unveiling they did was to make sure that they package these drivers wherever they are, whatever category they fall into. If they are in the park, corporates, companies, any individual drivers, they have put one or two things together for you so that you can enjoy this profession. I will take you on a tour to Abuja, the federal capital of our country, Nigeria, where the unveiling took place a few days ago. And you would listen and get some more information about the packages they have for drivers. Please join me. Let's go to Abuja.
And the Drivers Welfare Club, as it stands, as the name stands, I don't think there is or there are competitors or comparables. It stands on low. And as it is now, sir, it is only Drivers Welfare Club that have taken the bulls by the horn to do what other unions are not doing. Thank God we're in the ministry. You will attest to what I'm going to say here. An association cannot be under an association. And why I say so is, the club is a home for all the Nigerian drivers, irrespective of the category they belong to. It might interest you to know that the man speaking here has been an executive in the union for the past 28 years. I know what the drivers are facing. And me speaking here today, I am a professional driver, born to be a driver, and I'm proud to be a driver. You see, some of our drivers in this country, sir, if you agree with me, sir, go to Jabi Motor Park, where I managed for 10 good years. There are drivers at the age of 60. They are still sleeping inside the frame. There are drivers in Jabi Motorpark specifically. For the past 10 years, they don't even know roads to their various homes. And yet, those drivers pay stickles to this union. Where are your welfare packages? Who is taking care of their family? After service, who is taking care of them? At least in the ministry where you are coming from, sir, there are drivers there. There are incentives given to them. At old age, there are pensions they receive. There are the people in the garages who pay their pensions. Has any union come to tell the Minister of Transport that we pay drivers in the garages pension? Let them come and prove it. And I will be out to say no, because all the drivers are grappling with them. All these are the things we want the federal government to look onto. It is not like this, sir, that a man that paid an average of 1 million naira yearly to an organization, and at the end of the year, there is not even a bag of rice to go home with. It's an error. So if the Ministry of Transport has seen that to be right, I think Drivers Welfare Club is saying it's not right. Because the truth of the matter is, we have to speak the truth. And what is the truth? There are unions that are partnering with the Ministry of Transport. Which of the union? Where is the record that you have presented black and white papers to the minister that this has been what we've been doing for the drivers? Not just writing something on paper, go to the garage and ask questions. You make mention of Imo State just now. Yes, there are multiple unions in Imo State, which I'm aware. They just go out bringing one name, whatever you know. They end up collecting tolls from drivers along the website. And what Drivers Welfare Club is doing now, sir, I want you to take this message to the Honorable Minister. It is only Drivers Welfare Club of Nigeria in the whole of 704 local government council that is building an Oshremole motorbike without collecting the funds from the federal government, not taxing the drivers for that project. It's for the benefit of the government. Has union ever done that?
Sir, we can change the history of this country so that there will be a total revolution in the transport industry. You don't call me a common driver. You don't. If a common driver can have 4 graduates, what makes me common? It's not that driver I use to train my children, and you are calling me common. I'm not common.
But I know you must do so. I can be having a certificate of PhD in my pocket. And if I don't present it and say, this is my certificate of PhD.
What qualifies you to be a member is your valid driver's license. That is your PhD certificate. Get it and bring it to this place. And let me see that director that said he is not going to promote you. After serving for 15 years, no promotion, okay, we will go to. We will learn. Because you must tell me, or tell the organization, that you have been using Mustafa as a driver in your establishment for the past 7 years, 8 years. That man takes you to the office, takes your wife to the market, takes your children to the school, equally take your girlfriend to party. You will be enjoying yourself in the cafeteria, the man is seated inside the vehicle, and yet no promotion. Let me see that court that will ask me what is my right that I'm fighting for you that you must be promoted. Please not speak to us. We're interested in that. Calabama and the bike case is a very beautiful case. Give it to us. But we in Drivers Welfare Club, we cannot fight what we are not told or what we don't know. That with this, Abuja invested. We are giving all the drivers free registration. Then let's start from there and see whether drivers will not be respected. By February, we'll be hitting us. By April, we'll be hitting Lagos. But as it stands now, this is the headquarter. And other collaborators are coming. We are partnering with the Federal Road Safety Commission.
Provided you can drive, sir, come to the organization. As your retirement. Like himself now, looking at him as a senior member, as a director, maybe the next 5, 6 6 years and he'll be retiring. Less than that, sir. So what do you fall back to? He wants a pension that is going to be paid. But who pays the driver pension? Nobody. Nobody. So that is why you see the database we are unveiling is going to contain so many things. To understand that even if at all you are out of service, there are staples for you. There are things you must go back home. I think it has never happened the first time this thing is happening. Sir, a driver pays 100 naira in the motor park. Right? And that driver has stayed that motor park for 10 years. That 100 naira times 7 days, times 4 months, times a year. And you have a motor park, you have over 1,000 drivers multiplied than that year. You see that driver pays no less than 1 million naira into the coffer of the National Union on yearly basis. Then multiply it by the numbers of drivers that are there. Then go around the 704 local governments. So they are richer than NNPC. And yet, there is no welfare package. Because time is going to come to understand that by the time the custom officer will come to my domain and say, I want to see the paper of this vehicle, I will ask him where this vehicle will come out from. If a driver is on the highway just by the sex, sir, that is your office. Because by the time your car comes out, you will not be the keys in your pocket. If you know what kind of way, sir, if your car sharp, you sharp for him. If you sack, you come to Driver's Welfare Club. We ask questions. So if your master knows that you belong to a club that is fighting for you, honestly, he will respect you.
Yes.
He will respect you. Let's put it away. Like Nobel, there is no local government staff that will mess up with local government staff because Nobel is here. It is because your master knows that you don't belong to any organization that really stands for you. The money is not even the issue. Represent, in fact, bring yourself out. Let's know. There are 1,001 drivers all over. We are not just starting. This organization started in 2003, so it's not a baby.
My name is Comrade Daniel Onu Emmanuel from the University of Abuja. We are here today to be a participant in this Drivers Welfare Club. And there are a lot of things that we were not enjoying as drivers in the past, which is one of the main objectives of this club, Welfare Club, Drivers Welfare Club. So as it is, I think we've been enlightened so much concerning their main objective, their focus, and their mission before bringing drivers together under this Drivers Welfare Club. And as it is a good development from the look of things. So we are hoping that this will go far. It will go a long way to touch lives, like in the areas of drivers' orientation, drivers' character modification, drivers' way of attitude of communication, that is communication relationship. All these things are the things that drivers felt that because they are less important in the society and their profession are not regarded as important one. We are made to understand during this workshop in Drivers Welfare Club that drivers are not just common people, but they are also important people in the society.
I want all the drivers in Nigeria to support this program, to register as a member, because if you register as a member, there are so many benefits attached to it. You will not be treated anyhow again by your employee. Now, it can be easily to track down any unauthorized driver. Now, I'm encouraging you. It's not good for we to live in this country whereby everybody drive anyhow. There's nobody that is governing the whole driver affair all over the nation. I still want the government to support this so that this program can move very fast.
All drivers of the club.
Peace and harmony.
All drivers of the club.
Peace and harmony.
So this is the database of drivers of the club. From this moment, want to urge every driver in this country to start their registration online. Like I earlier pronounced, the registration for Drivers Welfare Club is free nationwide. It's free nationwide. Thank you very much.
Peace and harmony!
Drivers Welfare Club of Nigeria!
To provide loans to enable those who are interested to purchase vehicles or hire purchase and pay back at very affordable rates. We have also set up a cooperative society to handle other issues relating to the welfare of drivers and members and their families. Distinguished invitees, the National Drivers Database, NDDB, which makes it easier for the nation to effectively capture the details of all the drivers plying Nigeria's road and effectively articulate their needs to be able to provide for them whenever necessary. The scheme which we all flag off today will also help the federal government and especially security agents to track down criminals element among drivers who are engaged in one chance projects, kidnapping and car snatching.
That when you see a good thing coming on board, you embrace it. But the battle is not yet over. The struggle is not yet over. And the mission is not yet over. We are moving ahead and definitely we'll get to where we are going. And what we are saying is that drivers in this country must be respected. Drivers in this country must be respected.
And I want to assure you that in due course, you will receive a letter of a partnership with the Ministry of Transport. Thank you very much.
Welcome back to Asaba. I hope you enjoyed your trip to Abuja and everything that you saw there. They are for real. The packages are rich. We have the health package that will take care of you. Whether you are a company driver, the motor park driver, that is the commercial driver, or you are a driver driving yourself. Drivers now have package. Thus, Drivers Welfare Club of Nigeria has said no to the old school driving system. They want to package you, and the registration is for free. You have nothing to fear. It is for free. You will register. For you to register, you can dial my number and I will send you the information. For more clearer information, you could call my number which is on your screen and I will give you direction. Registration is for free. You don't have to see me before you register. All these are done online and you get access to this incentive. They will take care of your health, take care of your family, take care of your safety and fight for you when somebody wants to intimidate you, when your boss wants to turn you to a messenger or a car wash, all because you are his driver. You know where to run to. You have a club that will fight for you. So bye-bye to the old school driving. Now the drivers will be seeing now are corporate drivers. Driver, where go they drive keke, he wear suit. Where go drive keke, he wear tie. Where go they drive bus, he suit up. Only the perfume where they body go say wonderful. You know, you will enjoy your ride. Though, don't forget where you they stop, all because the driver is well dressed. And also, drivers, we had it right. You are encouraged to have a smartphone. It helps you a lot. Number one, to get GPRS of maps of places you are going to, the right direction, because it will be so on. It will be nice for a stranger in a town ask a driver, where can I get so place? And the driver say, no, I do not know the place. Meanwhile, you are in that town. With your smartphone, you could just Google it and it will take you there. Now, also with the smartphone, you will be getting updates from the club and know where to reach out to them. Your family is secured. You have pension now. Not the one you will drive and go home. Now, after the whole driving and driving, at the end of it all, you have pension. You have where to fall back on. Thank you so much, the president and the organizers and the sponsors of this wonderful club. I am a driver, like I said initially. I am a registered member. And that is why I'm telling you, call my number if you need more information. I insist, the registration is for free. Thank you very much. Enough of the driver's welfare. Now, moving on, we have our mentor, as usual, the Ojare, the one and only Ojare, the unchanging Ojare, the Ojare of Delta State, number one in Delta State. There is no other. Please, let's listen to Ojare, and that will take us to our town called the Onitsugbo in Delta State. Let's move there.
Ame Services Nigeria Limited, which is a limited liability. You people that went to school know what that means. Retired to an enterprise, Ahmed Motel on Chubo, now Ojare. Ahmed to Ojare that the revenue people could not stop using Ahmed services, that as did not see Ahmed services as a retired business. Instead, they are still coming to Hammer to come and hold Ahmed Motel. I asked a question, though I'm not privileged, I'm not so enlightened as a Yoruba man's way, but I know that a limited liability has nothing to do with an enterprise. They could not know the difference between a limited liability and an enterprise. Then my favorite name, Ojare, I now shifted to Ojare. That was how Ojare now came in. And for God's sake, both names are clean names. I've been enjoying myself with the two names, and it's still on. So now Ojare Motel.
Thank you so much for staying tuned. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your contributions. Thank you for your patronage. Thank you in advance for my supposed sponsors. I need sponsor. If you like this program, make una sponsor me. Sponsor me with waiting you get, and I will give you publicity. For gold and silver, I do not have. But what I have is publicity. I will sell your market for you. I will sell your business for you. Anywhere you are, in Nigeria, in Africa, because we are showing live on Star Times and Metro Digital. So we are in Africa. Anywhere you are, your goods and services will be seen. And please do not forget to continue to comment. Send your contributions to our social media platforms. And if you miss any of this episode, don't worry. Just go to our YouTube channel and you will watch everything you have to watch. It's been a wonderful evening with you. I love you so much, and that is why I feel so bad when I say I want to go, but I must go. Time na money, yo. Time na money. Time na money. My time is over, eh? So please be calm. Prepare your soul, prepare your mind for the coming of Jesus Christ. And we are all blessed. Thank you. Good night. Love you.
I am a marching band. I am the people. Oh, I am a helping hand. I am a hero. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say,